Hello and welcome, friends. I'm Chandrashree Rajput and you are watching the National TV. Friends, today I'm going to tell you about Oneplus 7 model, which launched recently, and I know you're too excited to know about it. So let's start. So friends, this year we are focusing on an even more premium segment. There is a slight change in strategy. You will see more premium technologies or even technologies not used in other phones in a OnePlus device this year. Today, we know that this device is the OnePlus 7 Pro, and as we go about reviewing it, we can see that OnePlus has indeed put some technologies in this phone that you won't find in any other smartphone right now. OnePlus 7 Pro is the most advanced OnePlus phone yet. It is also the most expensive OnePlus since the company entered the market, with prices starting at ₹48,999. The key question, considering that OnePlus has so far has made its name with good device priced greatly. So here's the killer look of OnePlus 7 Pro. OnePlus 7 is changing, and many will say improving, the design of its phone gradually since it launched the OnePlus 3. First, there were metal and straight lines giving its phone industrial looks. Then gradually glass came into the picture, edges become rounder, giving a warmer and more intimate look to the phones. Now, with the OnePlus 7 Pro, the OnePlus has created a phone that is its roundest yet. The OnePlus 7 Pro looks quite similar to the Samsung Galaxy S10 with its curved edge. The design flows around with no sharp edges except for the rear camera module that protrudes out of the otherwise smooth glass back cover. On the whole, this is a design that attracts attention, especially when you hold the ravishing Nebula Blue variant of the phone. Do note that at 206 grams, this is a relatively heavy smartphone. To get the full screen design and extremely thin bezel, OnePlus has pushed the earpiece to the top edge and stuffed important sensors like the proximity and auto brightness sensors underneath the display. There is no notch in this phone thanks to a motorized pop-up front camera module that we have seen before in Vivo and Oppo smartphone. The curved edges minimize the visual bulk of this size bezels, while the chin is extremely slim, something of an engineering marvel in the world of Android. The rear look like a mature evolution of the OnePlus 6T design, especially with a triple camera setup. Since the display now curves towards the edges, the frame is thin yet houses the usual buttons. And there is no headphone jack that died with the OnePlus 6T. And OnePlus, like Apple, has now stopped bundling the USB-C to 3.5mm headphone jack dongle. And now the display of OnePlus 7 Pro. Since OnePlus started teasing the OnePlus 7 Pro officially, the company CEO Pete Lau has talked again and again about how the company is focusing on offering world-class display this time that costs three times more than a conventional display in a phone. It seems worth the cost. This may sound exaggeration, but this is one of the best smartphone screen I have seen in a while. At 6.67 inches, it's largest enough for everything, whether that is gaming, web browsing, watching videos, and texting. AMOLED screens are always known for punchy colors, but OnePlus has tuned it for more natural tones. At first glance, the toned down colors may not appeal to some people, particularly if they are used to Samsung's punchy AMOLED screen, but at the same time, you will find the OnePlus 7 Pro screen more vibrantly colorful than what you see in a phone like the Google Pixel 3 XL. It's a well-balanced screen at a maximum screen resolution of Quad HD+. The display is noticeably sharper than OnePlus 6T display. The 90Hz refresh rate of the display meanwhile makes a difference. It's not just talk but substance too. Currently, there are just a few phones that have high refresh rate screens. I found that the faster refresh rate of the display makes the animations and user interface slick. One bit that I believe could have been better, and I am here comparing the OnePlus 7 Pro with the ₹1 lakh iPhone XS Max, is the screen brightness. Again, compared to a phone like the Pixel 3 XL, the OnePlus 7 Pro has a brighter screen, but it doesn't get as bright as the screens in the Galaxy S10 Plus or the iPhone XS Max, and that shows if you look at these phones in direct sunlight. And now let's talk about the performance of OnePlus 7 Pro, fast and faster. I don't recall anyone complaining about the performance of a OnePlus smartphone, and not since the company moved beyond the OnePlus 2 and the other OnePlus 10. Starting with OnePlus 3, the company has always offered great performance in its phone. The OnePlus 7 Pro outdoors handily the previous OnePlus phones as well as the existing Android phones. OnePlus 7 Pro, like other 2019 flagships, gets the Qualcomm Snapdragon 855 cheapest. The variant that I had for testing was the top end model. 12GB RAM and 256GB UFS 3.0 storage, the latter being another technology that is unique into the OnePlus 7 Pro right now. As usual, Oxygen OS based on Android 9 Pie is there to make efficient use of resources. Out of the box, the OnePlus 7 Pro is effortlessly fast. The Snapdragon 855 offers much more raw performance compared to the Snapdragon 845. But I believe it's the combination of extremely smooth screen and the fast read and write speed from the UFS 3.0 storage offers that gives the OnePlus 7 Pro an edge. Maybe 12GB RAM to help on the variant I reviewed as I switched between apps, including gaming app effortlessly and without any lags on this phone. There is one area where the OnePlus 7 Pro is much improved compared to earlier OnePlus phones. The in-display fingerprint sensor, likely because the OnePlus 7 Pro is using a newer fingerprint sensor. The sensor on the OnePlus 7 Pro is OnePlus Fast. You touch it and it unlocks. The face unlock, meanwhile, is slower because before it can work, the front camera needs to pop out. Also, I found that in good light, the face unlock works brilliantly, but in low light, it is iffy. Another aspect of OnePlus 7 Pro that deserves special mention is its audio performance. With a dual stereo speaker setup, the OnePlus 7 Pro can get decently loud, and there is often no need for a Bluetooth speaker to watch a video with a couple of friends. And when I talk about the camera of OnePlus 7 Pro, lenses and some magic. First, the numbers. The OnePlus 7 Pro scored 111 points in DxO Mark score. This is very impressive, and these scores come with camera hardware that too is seemingly very impressive. The main rear camera uses a 48 megapixel Sony made IMX586 sensor. The actual pixel size is small, but using pixel binning, the OnePlus 7 Pro main camera can churn out large 1.6 UM pixels. The camera supports both OIS and EIS. The second camera is telephoto unit with an 8 megapixel sensor and offers 3x optical zoom with OIS support. And the main camera can record up to 4000 videos at 60 FPS. And for the slow motion slide, it can do 780p videos at 480 FPS. As noted earlier, the started photos mode takes 12 megapixels as it uses pixels binning to join 4 pixels together to create super pixels. In the portrait mode, I found the details somewhat lacking, but the separation between the subject and the background is well detailed. The 48 megapixel mode offers more sharpness and get slightly more accurate color tone. In lower light, the camera does an aggressive correction to reduce noise and judiciously uses exposure to get the photo right. The results in most cases are impressive. In extremely low light, the normal mode struggled with photos coming out with noise and level of details going down. But here too, if you use the nightscape mode, it is possible to get fairly good looking and usable photos. Both the zoom lens and wide angle lens cameras are fun to use, albeit they click fantastic photos only in good light. In low light, their performance comes down a notch or two, with colors losing out on natural tones and lost the details evident in photos. While shooting 4000 videos at 60 fps and 30 fps, the camera ironed out the distortion in terms of brightness and exposure. The IOS and EIS ensure good video stability. Overall, OnePlus is offering a phone that has top-class camera performance. No, it's still not the Pixel class. Only Google Pixel offered that. But it is right up there with the sort of performance that you get with the phone like iPhone XS or the Galaxy S10. Now let's talk about the battery of the phone. The OnePlus 7 Pro gets a larger 4000 mAh battery. It's the biggest one ever to be stuffed in a OnePlus phone. This, when paired with well-optimized Oxygen OS, offers entire day's battery life even with heavy uses. The OnePlus 7 Pro doesn't have wireless charging, but OnePlus has included the Fast Rep Charge 30 from the OnePlus 6T MC Laren edition with the phone. It charges the battery faster than the older 20-watt charger and goes from around 30% to 100% within an hour. For OnePlus, the OnePlus 7 Pro is very important phone. Year after year, its fans have asked for a no-holds-barred flagship phone. With the OnePlus 7 Pro, the company tries to answer the prayer of its fan, and it mostly succeeds. So today we talked about OnePlus 7 Pro, the details I tell you about this, the significations, the battery, and the more about this phone. And if you want this phone, then please go and buy this phone because this is a fantastic camera-based phone. And I tell you about the features of this phone. So this is all about for today. I will tell you more about the gadgets, the new gadgets, the launch gadgets. But for that, you have to watch the national TV. Please subscribe our channel, share our channel, and like our channel, the national TV. Thank you so much.